today? Great. Okay, so to formally start our lesson this morning, we will start it with a prayer. So I may request everyone to please stand up and also Kella to lead us the prayer. Okay, thank you, Kella. Okay, good morning, class. It's nice to see you again, too. Okay, you may now take your seat. Okay, who are absent today? Okay, we have two absent. We have Alcantara and Galan. Okay, Secretary Kylie, note the absent. Okay, so to begin our lesson, are you excited? Me too, I am excited. So to begin, we have first a short game. Okay, so for our short game, we have here the mechanics. So we will divide the class into four groups. Each group will be given five sets of words. Each set contains two words and will be given one at a time. The members will fold the two words into one, forming a new word. The group that can form the correct word will be given 1 point. And the group with the highest score after the game will be declared the winner. So, we already have our group. So, you will now form your circle or a small circle wherein you will place. Okay. So, group 1, 2, 3, and 4. So, I will be giving to you the materials one at a time. So, in our first word, okay. So, for first word, we have motor hotel. So what will be the word you can form with these two words, motor and hotel? Okay, start. Okay, let's see what will be the word. Let's check. Okay, the word is motel. Okay, everyone got the correct word or answer. Now, number two, we have smoke and fog. Okay, start. Okay, time is up. Let's see what can you form. What did you form? No, from the word smoke and fog, we have smog. Okay, only group one and two got the correct answer. Okay, for the third question. Okay, we have the emotion and icon. What will be the word can you form from that words? Emotion and icon. Start. Okay, time is up. Let's see. The answer is emoticon. Okay. The group 3, 4, and 2 got the correct answer. Okay, for the fourth word. Okay, let's see. The words are clap and crash. Okay, what will be the words you can form? Okay, time is up. Let's see. The word is clash. Okay, only group 1 got the correct answer. Okay, and for the last item, okay, here's your activity. The words are spoon and fork. Start. Okay, time is up. Let's see. Okay. The word is spork. Okay, group 1 got only the correct answer. So, our winner for this round is the group 1. Okay, let's give them a round of applause. Good job, group 1. Okay, now, you may now go back to your seats. Okay, Based on our game or activity that we had, what could be our lesson this morning? Yes, Kayla. Okay. Mm-hmm. Is it about compound word? How about you, Kayla? Okay. Our lesson, can you state it in a complete sentence? Okay, very good. So our lesson this morning is about blended words. Specifically, our objective this morning is to infer the meaning of unfamiliar words based on given context clues and other strategies. So we will focus on inferring the meaning of unfamiliar blended words based on given context clues. So we will infer the meaning based on the word parts that is given. So I have here a sentence. Everybody, kindly read the sentence. I ate my brunch at the canteen since I haven't eaten my breakfast and lunch. Now look at the underlined word brunch. From the word brunch, what do you think is the word parts or original word of brunch? Again, what do you think is the word parts or original words of brunch? Anybody? Angeline. Any idea? Yes, Megan. Very good. The word parts of the word brunch are breakfast and lunch. So when we form breakfast and lunch, we can form the word brunch. Now, from the word breakfast and lunch, what do you think is the meaning of the word brunch? Again, from the word or word parts, breakfast and lunch, what could be or what do you think is the meaning of the word brunch? Yes, Michael. When you skip your breakfast, okay. More, any idea? Yes, JM. A late morning meal. Okay, you have an idea. Okay. Yes, Krishana. When we say brunch, okay, very good. When we say brunch, it is a late morning meal eaten instead of breakfast and lunch. So you skip your breakfast, so a late morning meal eaten instead of breakfast and lunch. So that is the meaning of the word brunch. Okay, now, since you ate your breakfast late, do you think a late morning meal can be good to your health or our health? When you skip your breakfast, is it good to our health? Anybody from the class who can give an idea? Yes, Lawrence. No, yes, why do you think it is not good to our health? Okay, very good, you have an idea. Eat? Any idea? Yes, Anna? Okay, it can affect our brain when we forgot to eat our breakfast. Aside from that, yes, Megan, again. Megan? Okay, you can focus on your lesson. So if some of you did not eat their breakfast, so probably they cannot focus on their lesson. Why do you think they can focus? Yes, Christopher. Very good, because they are feel so tired. They are dizzy. They feel dizzy. Okay, so you have your idea. Very good. Each one of you gave an idea. So when eating late or late morning meal is not good to our health because it can affect our brain. Okay, and also it cannot give, or it can, or you can focus to our lesson because you can feel dizzy or you are feel sleepy because you are hungry. You can be easily hungry. Kaya, it is better to eat your breakfast on time. Tandaan nyo yan ha? Remember that one. Okay, so proceed. Let's now proceed. I have here a video, a short video about blended words. So you can take down notes and focus on the video. Okay, blended words. Blending. A blend is a word formed from parts of two or more other words. Parts of two. Sample, breakfast and lunch, that is its original word. Then from the word lag, the original word are breath and lag. So we can form lag. Internet. What are the original words? We have international network. Okay, the word email. That is electronic mail. The word notebook. Note and book. Can also be a compound word. The word smug. Smoke. Fog. Spork. The words, original words are spoon and fork. So do you have any more blended words or ideas? So on your book, on page 63, we have there some examples of a blended words and their meanings on page 63. Okay, the word blog comes from the original word web and blog. What is the meaning of the word blog? Yes, Angeline. Yes, very good. It is a record of performance, progress, etc. online. How about the word blitz? What are the original words of the word leads? Yes, Megan? Okay, the word is glamour and glitz. And what is the meaning of glitz, Kela? Okay, very good. Extravagant showiness. How about blush? What are the original words of blush? Yes, Krishana? Okay, blood and butch. And what is the meaning, Kyla? Okay, an eruption on the skin. So, you can study this one or you can read. Now, who can read the remember part? Yes, Mark? Okay, when you say blended words, everybody read. Blended words consist of two words whose parts are folded into one, forming a new word with another meaning. So, we have now a group activity. Okay, same group. Group 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then you can form with your group later. But before you can go with your group, I will first read the mechanics of our activity. So, each group will be given materials for them to answer. Each group will be given 5 minutes to perform the activity and 2 minutes to present the output. 5 minutes only. And then 2 minutes to present your output. And then Each group will be evaluated using the rubrics. So here is your rubrics. 10 points will be given to your group if you show eagerness and cooperation to do the task. So each one is a great help to the group. Cooperation. Next. 9 points will be given to your group if you show eagerness and cooperation to do the task. It means that good follower. Some of you are only following or a good follower. Next, 8 points will be given to your group if they participated but late with teacher's supervision. Okay, next, 7 group will be given if the activity was done but does not show eagerness to participate. And 6 points will be given to the group who shows no interest in participating the activity. So, in group 1, here is your task. You will arrange the jumbled letter to get the blended words and infer the meaning using the word parts. So, you will arrange this one, then you write your answers, then later when you report, you will report through singing. Kakanta kayo. Next, group 2, fill in the blank with a given blended word and infer the meaning using its word parts. You will get the meaning. Then you will report your answer to a home. Next, group 3, determine the 2 original words of the underlined blended word and infer the meaning using the word parts. Report the answer to a rap. So, celebrities usually attend parties with the, okay, then you will answer. And for the group 4, look for the blended words inside the box and infer the meaning using the word parts. Then you will report your answer through a role playing. So, again, for the group 1, you will report your output through singing. The group 2 will be home. Group 3 is rap. Then the group 4 will do the role playing. So, do you have any question? If there is none, you can now proceed to your respective places. But remember, when you make a noise with your group, a 1 point deduction, -1 to your final score. Are we clear? Okay, so if you don't have any question, you can now form your groups silently. Okay, your 5 minutes starts now. So you can now go back to your respective seats. Okay, and give yourself a round of applause for a job well done. And especially to the group 2 who got 10 points. Okay, now. I have a question. What do you think is the importance of eating your meal on time, Angeline? Okay, you have an idea. Yes, Krishana. Okay, very good. So, eating, it is important to eat our breakfast or meal on time so that it can give us energy and it can have or give us focus on our lesson. So, and we can do better in our class. And what do you think is the or blended words. Yes, Kayla. Yes, blended words is consist or are consist of two words whose parts are folded into one, forming a new word with another meaning. And how do we infer the meaning of unfamiliar blended words? Kala. Yes, very good. Through its word parts or original parts, we infer the meaning of the unfamiliar blended words through analyzing its word parts or its two original words. So, do you have any question? Do you find it difficult, our lesson this morning? Okay, very good. So, for our evaluation, I have here a paper, a fact sheet, to be given to you. So, you will answer here on the paper. Just write your name, then your grade, and section. Okay, are you done? Okay, since everyone is done, we will check. Okay, for number one. So, direction, infer the meaning of unfamiliar blended words using its given word parts and encircle the letter of the correct answer. So, number one, smoke. Number one, smug. From the original word smug. Smoked and fog. What would be the meaning? Yes, Lawrence. Okay, very good. Number one, a fog made of heavier and darker by smoke and chemical fume. Next, number two, cyber. Yes, Michael. The answer is? Okay, letter B, an automated or computerized plant or animal. Next, number three, motorbike. What is the word? What is the meaning of the word motorbike? Angeline. Okay, letter C, a lightweight motorcycle. Number four, we have blog. What would be the meaning of the word blog? Yes, Christopher. Very good. It is a record of performance, progress, etc. online. And that's number five, twiddle. From the original word, twist and fiddle. Okay, yes, Christopher, for number five, we have twiddle. What would be the meaning? Okay, correct. It is letter B, to turn lightly to the item. Okay, now we turn the paper to the owner. Okay, who among you got the scores of 4 and 5? Okay. Okay, so very good. So may you kindly pass your paper to your center aisle. And leader, kindly collect the papers. Okay, so that ends our lesson this morning. Goodbye and thank you, class. Okay, see you tomorrow. Bye. I love you.